Hi, I'm Josh from eSpares, and in this video, I'm going to be helping you to diagnose motor problems in your washing machine. Now, in most cases, motor problems in your washing machine are going to be caused by worn carbon brushes. These are designed to come into contact with the moving part of the motor, which is called the armature, and pass power through it, but they do wear down over time, so obviously they will need to be replaced. How would you know if the brushes are worn? If the machine is filling and emptying as normal, but the drum isn't turning, or if it's making some sort of spluttering noise, or if you can see sparking coming from underneath the front of the machine, these are all likely to be caused by worn brushes and you need to replace them. And you can see how to replace carbon brushes in another eSpares video. Now, although that does cover most instances of motor faults in a washing machine, there are a few occasions where it may be due to the motor itself. So for safety, I've unplugged this machine first, and I'm just going to take the motor out of this machine and we'll have a more close look at it to see where problems might arise. Now I've got the motor out of the machine, I've just popped it down on some cardboard to protect both the motor and the top of the machine as well. I'm going to turn it onto its side, and here we can see there's a multi-plug with wires going off to various parts of the motor. If we take a look at the first two wires, these red ones, these go to a sensor here at the end of the motor. Now this sensor takes a reading from the armature of how fast it's spinning, and that measurement is then sent to the control board, and from that measurement the control board can determine how fast the drum is spinning. Now if the sensor is faulty, it's going to take the wrong reading, send the wrong measurement to the control board, and as a result the drum will spin very, very fast and then stop, and that'll continue in a cycle. If that's happening on your machine, you can test the sensor using a multimeter. Just by popping the probes of the meter into either of the red terminals, like so. And for a working sensor, I'd want to see any reading that wasn't a short circuit or an infinite reading. And here I'm getting a reading of about 70 to 71 ohms, so that would indicate that the sensor is okay. Moving on to the next two wires, we have a blue and a purple, and these go to the carbon brushes on either side of the armature here. So if I just pop the probes into those two terminals, for a working connection here, I'd want a reading of somewhere between 1 and 7 ohms, depending on the type of motor that I was working on. And here, I'm getting about 5 ohms. So that would indicate that it's okay. And then we have three more wires here at the end of the plug, and these go to the field windings around the side of the motor. And again, for a working connection, I'd want somewhere between 1 and 7 ohms. So if I pop it into these first two terminals, I'm getting about 3.5 ohms. These two, about 3 ohms. And these two, about 1.5 ohms. So all of these connections are good, and that would indicate that the motor is fully functional. Now, if when you test your motor, you get readings that are dramatically different to any of these readings, that would indicate that your motor's got a fault and you're gonna need to replace the entire thing. While you've got the motor out of the machine, it's a good opportunity to have a look at the carbon brushes as well and see how worn down they are. You can just unscrew them either side here and just have a look at how much material is left on them to determine how worn they are. Spares for washing machines and other appliances are available on the eSpares website. Thanks for watching.